Hello, my friends, and welcome back to another video here for you on Life's Biggest Questions. I'm your host, Jarred Bronstein, and we got a follow-up to our video, What If Great White Sharks Doubled in Size? Based off of our previous follow-up videos, where we replied to some comments from the original videos, you guys seem to enjoy them. We get tons of positive comments and thumbs up, so please continue to do that if you want to see more of these part 2 videos. If you haven't seen the prequel to this video, titled What If Great White Sharks Doubled in Size, I'd strongly recommend you do that now. Watching this video just won't make much sense otherwise. But if you've already committed to watching this one before the first installation, well, welcome aboard. As previously mentioned in the follow-up videos, we replied to a handful of comments you guys left us on the original video and explore those ideas, comments, or questions even more. So let's start off with a comment from Blaise Fontenat who said, "That's pretty much the return of the Megalodon." Yeah, pretty much. And I mean, the Megalodon didn't wipe out all the entire human race, so who's to say great whites doubling in size would? Okay, fine, humans weren't necessarily around when the Megalodon roamed the waters, but it's actually believed great whites could have been the reason the Megalodon went extinct in the first place. Seriously, a new study suggested that great whites made their debut in the ocean about 400,000 years before it's believed the Megalodon went extinct. Not to say that the great whites necessarily killed Megalodons themselves, but maybe their arrival left little to no food for these approximately 60-foot sharks. But again, if great whites doubled in size, they'd be 40 feet, so it's unclear if they'd suffer the same fate as the Megalodon, if they were to double in size in the first place. Either way, I'm not too upset a 60-foot shark is no longer roaming the waters. Night Ike said, "I'm terrified of sharks." Thanks for that clip at the end. Now, for those of you that didn't want to go to our first video, it's a massive shark eating a person lounging in the ocean on a floaty before taking a bite out of a massive hanging shark on a boat. It's better if you just see the clip, but listen, Knight, you got nothing to worry about. I mean, the shark eating the person in one bite, well, that might be possible depending how small you are, but no shark is nearly that big, nor do they jump out of the water for food all that often. I mean, I will say it does happen, but it's not very common. And if it were to happen, I can tell you right now, it definitely would not be able to jump that high. So as long as you're not on a small little boat, I think you'll be okay. Or just do what I do and stay as far away from the water as possible. I'm good on land, thank you very much. Ryan Shaw said, "Honestly, they'd go extinct due to starvation and climate change wouldn't support such a large fuel-burning fishy." Unfortunately, I can't agree nor disagree here because we don't know for sure. We're assuming if they were to double in size based off of our previous video, so would their appetite. But what if it didn't? What if the size of their stomachs stayed the same and other parts of their body just got bigger? Also, what if they just learned to adapt and started consuming other types of food? We really don't know for sure, but I think sharks are smart enough to go where the food is. They'd know when it was running low in one area, so they'd migrate elsewhere. But maybe them doubling in size could make them more aggressive toward one another. Maybe they'd fight each other for food. Who knows? But I think seeing two 40-foot sharks going at it would be quite the sight to see. York God 1 said, "I thought orcas are now kings since they hunt great whites." It really depends who you ask. Technically, they're both apex predators, meaning they're at the top of the food chain. Yes, orcas, also known as killer whales, do hunt great white sharks. They're bigger, both in size and weight, and have been proven to be powerful enough to kill great whites. But with that being said, killer whales are believed to live, on average, between 30 and 50 years in the wild. Great whites live, on average, about 70 years, with some possibly living past 100 years. So just because killer whales can, and sometimes do attack great whites, you also need to consider who's roaming the waters longer. A 60-year-old great white shark most likely wouldn't have any trouble going after a baby killer whale. It seems the debate of the king of the ocean has been going on for many years. Technically, killer whales would be the king because they have no natural predators, aside from humans, of course. But killer whales also hunt in packs. The likeliness of a baby killer whale being by itself, well, slim to none. If it was a one-on-one fight though between a great white shark and a killer whale, who knows who would win for sure? I mean, of course, killer whales are faster and bigger, but sharks have rows and rows of teeth that could do some serious damage to a killer whale. On top of this, killer whales are more intelligent, so it really depends on how much value you put on these things to determine, officially, who the king of the ocean is. Yuvraj Kinda said, "This guy is the best commentator so far from LBQ," but then Lava Pop said, "His voice makes me miss the other voice actors tremendously, so I'm not really sure how to feel." I hope you guys enjoy listening to my voice. I mean, clearly some do and some don't, which is fine. That's why we have more than one host on this channel. Variety is definitely important and you can't win everyone over. With that being said, I'm always looking to improve, so if you guys have any suggestions or ways you feel I could improve, let me know in the comments down below. I know when I first started, a lot of you said I speak too fast. I'm normally a fast talker, but have made a point to slow my speech while recording these videos. probably doesn't help that I usually have some espresso beforehand, but hey, it is what it is. DeJuan Watkins said, "Go Cowboys, you better hope wheelchair Wentz makes it through the whole season." Now, I left this comment for last because if I didn't, the entire video would be me ripping apart the Cowboys. And I'll be honest, I'm recording this video on the Monday following a heartbreaking Eagles loss to the Falcons. At the time of this recording, the Cowboys are 2-0, and the Eagles are 1-1. But we almost won the game without our two-star receivers. The Cowboys beat the Giants and Redskins. Congrats. That's like me bragging that I'm stronger than a four-year-old. But hey, it's what Cowboys fans do, right? They just hold on to any hope that they're actually a good team. My definition of a good team is a team that wins. The Eagles won a Super Bowl 2 years ago. The Cowboys haven't made it past the second round of the playoffs since 1995 when they won the Super Bowl. All I'm saying is, we'll see what happens in January when the Eagles not only win the division, but make a decent run. For now, Cowboy fans, I'd recommend starting a petition to get Jerry Jones out because he's clearly not doing what it takes to put together a winning team like he did in the past. Just a thought. Then again, you guys love talking about the past, so enjoy that glory while you can. And on that note, we'll wrap this one up, guys. If you enjoyed the video, you gotta let us know by giving us a good old thumbs up. Make sure you are subscribed and ring that bell notification. Follow the entire LBQ team on Instagram. And of course, drop some comments down below with your thoughts on this one. I've been your host, Jarred Bronstein, and we'll see you guys in the next one.